This is JJ at the 300th consecutive cryptocurrency meetup in Manchester, New Hampshire, Murphy's Tap Room. And I've got two guys here from LBRY. We're going to talk about stuff. We've got Kay and Amit. Welcome, guys.
Thank you.
Who are you and what do you do at LBRY?
Hello, I'm Kay Kurokawa. I work on mostly the blockchain part of LBRY.
Excellent. And Amit, what do you do?
Well, I'm Amit Tulshan. I'm from India, and I'm an internet LBRY. I work on the protocol side. So the most of the data handling part, and now the components like come together and all. Yeah.
Posting video is a big deal, and you guys have been working on it for, you know, a couple months, a year, how long, something like that?
At least a year and a half.
Yeah.
It goes by fast.
So what's the current stage of your development, and what's the next steps?
We're pretty close to beta.
Okay.
The software is already out. You can use it. You can watch videos. Blockchain development is mostly about security trade-offs. So you want to make a decision about the trade-off between security and innovation. The difficult part is, you know, how do you make it innovative and easy for people to use without sacrificing security?
You're interacting with a network, right? You're interacting with a lot of other pieces that are moving, and so you kind of like, in order to test things, don't you have to sort of push the pieces and wait for their response, that sort of stuff? Or is it more how it interacts?
We actually have a regression test, something we call a regression test server. That's short for regression testing. So in that, we can like get the blocks that we required. In general, we would have to wait for a response from the network. But when using a regression testing server, we can get that response instantly. Like we can create that response ourselves. So we do our programming on that part. We like whatever challenges and bugs we face, we fix it using while testing on that, and then we like deploy it to the production.
Who stores the data? Where's the
basically
data stored?
You have the data. For example, if I am uploading a content, so that content would be on my PC. And if you want to download it, then first you download it through me. It's kind of like how BitTorrent works, not exactly like it. So the thing that is different from BitTorrent is like in BitTorrent, I cannot search for content. So in this one, the content which I put up, you can actually search for content, and then you can have your name on that. Like you can specify by what name your content goes. So I am the first point of distribution, and then since now you have the content, you download it from me. Now the other, like if some third person wants to download it, like he can download from both of us.
Okay.
So yeah, so that's how the network grows.
Okay. Good. Thanks.
Yeah.